Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss the photoelectric effect. The phenomena of photoelectric emission was discovered in 1887 by Henry Hertz during his electromagnetic wave experiment. The term photoelectric is made up of two terms, light and electron. The wave nature of light was well established by the end of 19th century. The phenomena of interference, diffraction and polarization were explained in a natural and satisfactory way by the wave picture of light. According to this picture, light is an example of electromagnetic radiation. So, electromagnetic radiation is quantized and is made up of photons. These photons is elementary element of light, or we can simply say that light is made up of photons. Light energy is not emitted continuously, but it is emitted intermittently by individual amount of energy called the quantum of energy. These quanta travel in space in the form of bundles or packets known as photons. These photons carry a definite amount of energy with them, and the energy of these photons was calculated by using the equation E is equal to h nu, where E is energy in electron volt, h is Planck's constant, which has the value of 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule per second, and nu is the frequency of light in hertz. It can be said that light is carried over space by photons. So, the absorption and emission of light takes place when light of frequency nu is absorbed by an atom. The one photon is transferred from light to the atom. In the absorption process, the photon disappears and the atom absorb it. In the emission event, the light of frequency nu is emitted by an atom. Here, an energy h nu is transferred from the atom to the light. So, we can say that absorption and emission of photon is done by the atom. So, this atom also has some important properties, such as photon describe the properties of particles of the wave and not the overall properties of wave itself. Also, photon does not have any mass, photon does not have any charge and are not deflected by electric or magnetic field. In empty space, the photon moves at speed of light. After knowing the properties of photon, we can study the photoelectric effect. When light falls on metal surface, some electrons near the surface absorb an enough energy from the incident radiation to overcome the attraction of positive ions in the material of the surface. After gaining sufficient energy from the incident light, the electron escape from the surface of the metal into the surrounding. So, this process of emission of electron from the metal surface is called photoelectric effect, or we can simply define the photoelectric effect as whenever light falls on photosensitive substances, it emits electrons. This process of emission of electron from metal surface when illuminated by light of suitable wavelength is called photoelectric effect. After discovery of electrons, these emitted electrons are termed as photoelectrons, and we have to study the nature of these photoelectrons or emitted photoparticles. In order to study the nature of these photoparticles or photoelectrons, consider the experimental arrangement as shown. It consists of evacuated or quartz bulb having the photosensitive plate C and another metal plate A, when monochromatic light is incident on the cathode C, the electrons are emitted by the plate C and are collected by the plate A. So plate A is called the collector and plate C is called the emitter. The battery maintains the potential difference between plates A and C that can be varied with the help of this rheostat. Then the polarity of the batteries between C and A can be reversed. Thus, the plate A can be maintained at desired positive or negative potential with respect to the emitter C. When the collector plate A is connected to the positive terminal with respect to the emitter C, the electrons are attracted towards the anode A and it shows the deflection in the galvanometer A. So when another case, when the light is incident on the anode A, then there is no current in the circuit as there is no deflection in the galvanometer. So after these observation, we can say that the emitted photoparticles must be negatively charged. So in this video, we have discussed the nature of light, then absorption and emission of light, also the properties of photons, photoelectric effect, and nature of photoparticles. In next video, I am going to discuss the Lenard's method to determine charge to mass ratio for the photoparticles. Thank you.